Hi, what's going on, everybody? Hold on, let me move my mic a little bit more. All right, Smokeyplays here on Thanksgiving. Thankful for everything. Hopefully, y'all have a good Thanksgiving, and if you don't celebrate, that's cool too. Just another day, Thursday, and I'm off work tomorrow, and I'm off work for Saturday, Sunday, obviously. So 4-day weekend starting today. Here we go, ROTK. Let's get back to where we left off. So I got a little doobie here on my light. For the beginning of the video, okay. Make sure that's good. Let's sum up the last video if you didn't watch it, episode 7. So what happened was I made a good attack on Yuan Shu's third city, and I took it over. Did pretty good. Everything worked out. And then what happened was he attacked really quick after I said he won't retaliate quick. He retaliated quick, and Sun Jian himself, he got mad about it. So we defended the attack, we attacked really quick. And then we did try to attack him with our retaliation. And that didn't work. And it ends up with the death of my leader, Sun Jian. His son was captured, so we cannot make his son the heir and the new leader, which we wanted to do, which is how history went. So Zhou Yu, the next up in line, one of our best generals, even though he was recently joined, if you know anything about this period of history, Zhou Yu is actually a very skilled strategist. Military leader, so he's our new guy and head honcho, and we're gonna start with that. All right. So here we go. Shengyang. We got three officers in our recently captured city. It's August and we're out of gold because we spent it all on military. No merchants here to sell food. We can ask Liu Yan for help, or we can make an exchange. Let's ask Liu Yan for 90 gold. I doubt he's gonna say yes. You never know. That would be acceptable. Nice. So a friendly gesture from our ally. He hands over 90 gold. And with that 90 gold, and we want to spend it wisely. Song Guo. Let's try to recruit him. And nope, he refused to join us. So we're gonna hold on to that 90 gold because we can't do anything else this turn. So we have Lu Jiang, our newly found city, and Han Zi. He's there alone, but now we sent him a new officer to accompany him. Let's see who that is. I'm pretty sure it's Hong Zhu. Yeah, it is. Hong Zhu. One of our old captives. He can search. We gotta get that popular support in that city. We gotta get the popular support up. Here we have Man Chong, one of our pretty much. Oh. Jin Zhuang. Okay. I remember he was holding one of the commentaries. In one of the scenarios, you can start with him. So it would be good to have him on our side. Let's offer him gold. Good, he agreed. Finally, we get some help. Finally, we get some help when we need it. His skills are very mediocre, but it's good to have another officer. Can he be a general or no? Not a general. He has to be a military advisor. His skills are kind of lacking. And that's all we can really do. Finally adding a little bit. We still need a general. Here we have Chai Sang, one of our connector cities. Zhu Mao is in charge of it. He's been moving around a lot lately because he's one of our generals that we can rely on to just that can hold any places. They'd still have it under our control.
So for that, all I can say is develop the economy. The new year is coming. I was going to say the farmland, but we'll take a hit just to get our economy up this turn. Play out Hua. Search for two turns. Alright, Hong Zhu and Liu Jiang is having a secret meeting with someone. That's not good. They're trying to get him to plot a twist. They're trying to get him to leave. Join their side. Wang Lang goes to battle with Yan Baihu for the fourth time. Never been successful, as you can tell. He's trapped in that corner. Let's see if he gets out. Wow. Finally, he breaks. And Wang Lang has exterminated Yan Baihu. Nope, he was set free, but he still exterminated his faction. Even though he was set free and we got a couple people in exile. There's like three leaders in exile. Liu Yang has revoked our alliance. We cannot trust him anymore. Liu Yang is going to attack us at Hanzi City. He has 6,200 soldiers. We will request reinforcements from Zhu Miao. And maybe from this city as well, if they let us. No. Only one set of reinforcements. So I wish we could see the numbers better. Liao Hua, head on over to help us. And then Hanzi has this huge army. Oh, so we're pretty good. We're sitting pretty good. Especially with Hanzu. I think we got this one. Hopefully we can capture some of his generals. We need generals. That's what we can look forward to in an offense like this. So we'll place Hanzi himself with his large amount of troops. Wang Zhu. And we have reinforcements on the way. Hanzi, very smart commander-in-chief, so he can place some pitfalls. Only certain advisors can do that. And all we gotta do is wait. Well, we placed the pitfall in the wrong spot, but it's all good. It's not gonna hurt us. Got this smoking disjoint still burning. Burning good, too. Romance of the Three Kingdoms, Dragon of Destiny, Super Nintendo. Sun Jian, Conquest, and Sun Jian has died and faded into history. Now Zhou Yu, famous notorious general from the Southern Southlands, has rise to the occasion and became our new faction leader. So they're attacking, or what I believe is the North Gate. Hanzi moving to reinforce once they breach. Once again, I've been making this my point in the last couple episodes that I need to get my equipment up. We're still using way too many foot soldiers. So let's move them back and let our reinforcements be able to reach. Nice. They got one more turn. There we go. By then, hopefully our reinforcements will be able to reach. No, you can't move into the wall, sir. So he marches in. I imagine he is pretty close to Hanzi right here. Hopefully the reinforcements get here to help. Even though Hanzi has a towering army. Towering troop. We're going to hit him with a charge. My 11,000 men. Over his 6,000. And we're pretty much going to just gang up on him, beat him down, and try to capture his general. So Liu Yang, we get our first contact with Liu Yang. We've had three enemies. One is totally defeated, although we could not take his head ourselves. Liu Biao. And then Yuan Shu, we're currently at war in the Central Lands. And now Liu Yong. With a very, very, very vain attempt of an attack on us. He should know better next time. Hansi's got a deep amount of troops. Oh no! Son of a biscuit! Fuck! Are you serious? Oh, we're coming back next turn. Are you serious? We surrendered a castle and took an L. What an idiot mistake. It's alright. You saw how little his force was. We're not letting that fly for any longer than 1 second. Right now I'm back. Can't believe I made a dummy move. Well, I definitely can believe it. I make a lot of dummy moves. Uh-oh, Liu Yan under attack. Ma Tang, finally getting time to build up and actually spread for once. But he takes an L as our ally Liu Yan feigns him off. So Zhou Yu not happy with the news that he loses Liu Jiang due to a fluke strategy. So September, it's not time for the new season yet, and that's kind of hurting us. Zhou Yu, just search for now. Zhong Zhong, you're not good at drafting, but take all our gold and draft. Okay. Man Zhong recently recruited Jing Zhong. Now, if I wanted to, I could move him. I'm thinking about it. There's so many places I need important generals. To the left. To the north. For now, we're going to keep him here. This is a prime land we want to keep, so develop the farms, but he is good gold here. And now with our new secondary general here, we can develop good troops. Give him 1,400. Give Man Chong the rest. Well, the little J went out, so I'll put it out for now. Now, we took a sad loss here, but here we are. Time to go back to war. Ah, we can't. We gotta wait one turn. Son of a biscuit. Let's just rally our guys. Hanzi, rally. You guys need to get ready to go back to war. There's no fluke going on. Liu Yan has angered me. Liu Yan has become one of my arch fucking nemesis, not ally. I mean, Yuan Shu is pretty. Oh. I spoke too soon as he attacks our city in Zhang Yang. I believe I might not be able to defend it either. Two losses in one episode. Good defense. Great. Great defense. Should we counter him? Great defense. Ooh, captured Guo Xi. A great warring fighter, but not a loyal general at all. Hard decision here. Pretty grimy type character, but we need as many people as we can get. So let's just improve his loyalty. Uh-oh. Hong Zhu having another secret meeting. They're trying to get him to flip in battle. He didn't flip in that last battle, but I don't think he had time. Man, I would attack right now. Who else is in this city? Because we need other generals, and it's really hurting us if we don't have enough to hold all our cities. None of these guys can hold a city here, so at this point, we can just train and rally here as well. Alright, not much to do there. So we're in a bit of a slump. Oh, okay. This is obvious. Man Chong, you have to assist us in this war. Your time has come. Jin Zhuan, you can hold this till I get a general. Better? Here we go. Back to take our land from Liu Yong. He angered me badly. Zhu Miao's first battle. Han Zi going back to battle. Hong Zhu, even though we can't trust him, has got a lot of troops and we need to take him as well. Han Zi says the deck is stacked in our favor. A nice card reference. So if we win, I'll spark that little J up. What is this question now? Asking for reinforcements? I mean, we don't need it. Yu Jin, of course, refused to join invasion. He's lucky we're giving him that much power. We need a general that I can control to occupy some of our cities. But until then, we'll take this land back from Liu Yong just like easy. Okay, the only problem is we don't have any archers or cavalry. We just outnumber them by a lot. So before Liu Yong attacked me, he should have had his wits about him and known that I was going to hit this retaliation that quick. But it's alright. He's a faltering leader. But his reinforcements arrived, so it's going to be better numbers for him now. We're still going to spank him, just like a little baby. We need to get our equipment up, so I need to remind myself that's a good task that we need to do. Now we have Man Chong also going to help us fight Yuan Shu, help Zhou Yu. Zhou Yu can't do it all himself. So they send reinforcements. It gives them a lot of troops, but we still have more. Definitely help them out. Makes it a way closer battle for them. And it could be archers and horses, so this is not going to be as easy as it was if he didn't send those guys. So we get a glimpse of what looks to be an arrow troop. Bow troop. Don't know how big it is. We've reached the south gate, and we're going to continue until we get inside and take everyone for captive. I might just capture him, not even recruit most of them. Unless I see like a really good one I'm surprised he had. And it's fictional mode, so you never know. He could have, you know, someone surprising. Like, oh, wow. Chen Gong. Like, the best example of that is when Liu Bei retreated and he had Zhen Yu with him. I'm like, oh, how'd you pick him up? How'd you convince him to join your little lab? Big ass, little ass, small ass. All kinds of asses. Uh-oh, they come out to initiate. So battle has started in front of the southern gates as the foot soldiers are clashing. Han Zi and Zhu Mao. Because of a fluke on an easy defense, Han Zi fluked and he let them sneak in and take our castle, surrender our castle. I mean, you need to remember that for the future when we're defending, not to give up our castle. Sure, it's happened to the best of us, the best Koei players, even though Koei, the older they got. Uh-oh, Zhang Ying challenged Han Zi to a personal duel. I will not accept it because I am pretty sure his military skills cannot be that great. Knowing that he's so good at diplomatic things and civil tasks. So we hit him with a double charge. Zhang Yin holding up their gate here. They're hitting us with fire bows. That's effective on their part. Other than that, hopefully we can force this guy to surrender or capture. So he fled. That's good. And the gate is now open. Still getting hit with fire bows. But we have our route now. See the numbers. Good. So we're towering over them. We need to get to that castle and attack their castle sooner the better. Alright, so all our foot soldiers flooding in the rain here in Liu Yang's newfound city of Lujiang. But we are taking it back because this is our city. We had it easily defended and we made a fluke attack. A fluke defense and it took it. It's all good. We're gonna get it back. This time we get Zhu Mao his first battle experience. It's the first time fighting, leading an army. It feels good because he's next to Hanzi. It felt good to have him have our back as well. When we lost the city, I noticed, wait a second, this one already has a governor that's a general, so we're going to definitely have some backup here. We're going to send him back home, though, once we take the city so he can control it. We can't have whoever's controlling it now for too long. Leo, whoever. Can't remember. We're getting some trouble from this bow troop, and Liu Cheng also challenged Hanzi to a battle. They must think I'm stupid. Successful charge. And we hit him really good. Surprised these troops still holding on there in front of the castle. Whoa, the game just glitched. Oh, I hit my foot on the keyboard. Holy crap, that scared me. I'm sorry, guys. Wow, that scared me. I was like, not in the middle of a video. That scared me. Everything got fast. I had my foot on the keyboard. Wow. And because of that, I get distracted and don't hit an attack. That scared my stoner ass. Alright, so this time we're going to be smart. I'm going to attack the main castle here. And then attack it here with him so we're getting spread. Simultaneous attack from them. We could have hit a 3 simultaneous attack too. That's what we'll do on the next turn. If he's still alive. Bow troop holding on. They must have a lot of men in the bow troop. And finally, Liu Cheng got captured. So we're capturing him for good. Let's see if we can do a simultaneous attack on their capital. And then move in. Successful. So two people attempted to get Hanzi to duel them in a one-on-one combat. And I don't know what they were thinking about that, but Hanzi declined both of them. It's going to be a good laugh when he gets back on the throne here in Lujian, a small city in the southland. But it's one that we definitely need to prove our conquest. Hopefully we can win, because for some reason when I'm attacking castles, I always seem to my troops go down faster. It actually angers me. In the rain. So we pretty much got him. They tried for a fireball and wasted an attempt. This is really going to give him that advantage. Uh-oh. Nope. They got it this time. Hong Xu's the one on fire. I might just leave him. Nah, I'm moving. We can't be petty to our guys, even if we don't trust him yet. I never trusted that guy, Hong Xu. Try a charge. Although, battle continue next month. So although I captured Liu Cheng and I kind of don't want to keep him on my side, he did hold us out really long when he was defending in front of the castle. So I don't know. You know, he made a good case. That's what I'm about to say. Shang Yong, things still going sideways. I see. Okay. One thing I want to do is appoint the new governor, Manchong. Yep. He's actually a general, so Peng Tong has to give up his troops. This gives me a chance to assign troops here. They hired Ma Wan while I was not in control as well, so that's cool. Cao Miao's been with us for a while, so you can hold that. And then we want the leader, the smartest one, Manchong. Who you appoint? Okay, it's done. Done deal. Okay. Can't develop no more. Can we search? We like searching here. Shang Zhong, go ahead and search for us. And rally the troops. We're going to war, believe it or not. Yuan Shu's going down, as well as Liu Yong. So we're in an eastern campaign and a central or northwestern campaign, almost near the Riverlands. Liu Yan controls all of the Riverlands. He controls all the western map. And he's going to be clashing with Dong Zhuo and Ma Teng, although he has an alliance with Zhuo. So Zhuo might keep his power steady for a while until Tao. Tao hasn't made many moves either. The blue and yellow banner. Okay, so the tax rate in this city, they changed it. They really changed it to 50. Because they were being petty. And that's why you can't trust. Well, that was Peng Tong. Maybe he was being smart. You know? On the brink of war, maybe he was being smart. First thing I'm going to do as new leader, new prefect, new governor, Manchong, himself search for new people. We're going to draft troops. Peng Tong, go ahead and do that. We got to make a smart decision here. $9,700 for Manchong. Give the new captive, Guoxi, a couple. He's not really trustable, but he is a good military tactician. So maybe we want to reward him as well, but we can't just yet. Can we develop still? Yes, we can. Farming's always good, even if it's good. Our economy went up from their tax rate. Our land cultivation really high. So at this point, let's buy some equipment. That's what we're low on. That's what we need. Ho Jun. Good at purchasing equipment. I say we purchase 3. Fucking, 7. Purchase 700 horses to make 1,000. And then we're going to sell some food to get our gold back to where it was. Not quite, but it did go up. At that rate, we might as well develop our farms with Liu Zhan and end the turn here. 2 months for 200 gold. Cultivate land, sir. Manchong making moves already as the new governor. We needed him in a more important spot anyway. Yuan Shao going to battle in the north. Attacking Beihai. No, from Beihai. To attack Ping Yuan with Liu Bei. Dong Zhuo coming in to either help or help one of them. I'm pretty sure it's Liu Bei. He's helping defend. Which is interesting. So, clean sweep. And our battle should be coming up here soon. Wow. He sent Dong Zhuo a lot of supplies for help. Helping him. Zhu Xu has left. Dong Zhuo's troops have invaded Wan. That can help us. If he wins, we will easily attack Yuan Shu on the brink on the next tournament. He lost. Maybe we should help in battering Yuan Shu by attacking his second city. And we're back in our battle in Lujiang, where we almost have a clear victory. And it was our city. We lost in an easy defense, so this is not necessarily a win for us because we had to go through all this. It should have just been an easy defense, and we wouldn't have to go through all this. There we go. Just like that. Zhu Xiao has fled, and we are going to spark up the rest of the gym. You're on Smokeyplays. Thanks for watching. And if you're smoking and watching some herb, let me know what you got going on. You got your rig or whatever. You got a bowl piece or blunt. Lu Chang. 35, 66 war, 61 army. We will recruit him, even though we said we weren't. He helped defend in front of that castle pretty good for Liu Yang. So, back to Zhou Yu. And I'm going to go to personnel and appoint. Fix the governorship here. Hanzi. And then once we get a chance, we'll move Zhu Mao back home, and then we'll appoint him as governor as well. So it's December. It's about to be New Year. We're going to get our gold. So I'm going to wait to attack till we get gold here. We need more troops. Although technically we'd be attacking from Manchong City, and this would only be sending reinforcements. So I might attack sooner than later. One thing about this game is you want to make sure your attacks are right. I mean, on the first difficulty setting, you can rush it and still get away with it, but to be logistic and to be right, you want to kind of plan it out. Alright, so I'm going slow because I'm smoking. But still thinking about how I'm going to go about this. We got tons of food here. So much food. That let's draft all soldiers. Let's actually hire them so they're like mercenaries and they're stronger. Manchon, go ahead. With all the gold we have. 1,100. We don't want to trust him too much, but we do want him to have a good amount because he's a good warrior. Tai Mao, he's been here long enough. So we're going to sell some food, Peng Tong. Now that Peng Tong don't have that governor responsibility, he's going to come in good handy as just a civil officer. Let's develop with the economy on our last turn before the new year as well. Alright, Hanzi claimed his land back and he's pissed off. Had to go through a lot to get that. First thing he wants to do, develop the farms here. And send Zhu Mao back, damn it, back home. He doesn't belong here. Take nothing with you, just go back and we'll appoint you as governor on our next turn. So we definitely need a draft with all the gold we have as well, because the new year's coming and we gotta get ready for this war with Liu Yong. Give all the troops to Hanzi, actually don't. Well, we will, but then we'll do it like that. And we need to buy some equipment too. What's our cavalry count look like? We'll buy 4 of those and get 10. So we got 1,000. End the turn here. Supplies were sent from Jiangling to Shenyang. Nice. Wow, Zhao Yuan left to serve under Kong Zhuo. That was a good convincing. Liu Yong going to war, attacking Lu Jiang again. With 4,600 weakling troops. Yes, we will request reinforcements. But then again, Zhu Mao's not the governor, so they might say no. And of course, we forgot to appoint our troops right, so we can't even take our cavalry. That sucks. At least we're defending. No reinforcements sent, and it's going to be a closer battle than we think. This time we're not giving up and surrendering to Casper. Alright, so Hanzi's going to start in the castle. Hangzhu right outside of it. Lu Cheng's going to be more like right here. Numbers look good on our part, but not by much. So we can just wait for him to come. Hopefully he doesn't have too many. I hope that's his only troop. Liu Yang, becoming the new Liu Biao. He's our new rival. And I don't have much good things to say about him. So we're right back to where we just were. Liu Yang attacking again in the same city. Liu Jiang. He wants it. He wants it, and he wants to take some of our Southlands. He wants that access to it. But he's going to see how strong we are soon. Because we're developing good, we just need more generals. We get 4 more generals and spread them out. We'll stack up on each of our cities. And we'll be able to supply all of our main military bases. Right now, it's so hard to do that. We can't move things around and help because we don't even have... Like, I didn't get reinforcements on this battle because I don't have a general. I do, Zhu Mao, but I didn't delegate him yet. Didn't appoint him. So they've breached our walls. Their 1 weekly troop is heading on in. We'll save Hanzi for last, and we'll see if our 2 main forces will attack him first. We'll create this line formation, and the rain comes down. There we we go. We're engaging. Right outside the castle. Uh-oh. Who switched? Somebody switched and joined their side. I knew it was coming. Was it Liu Chang? I should have captured him. I knew it. Liu Chang switched and joined her side. Took the troops he had with him. I knew I should have captured that damn man. That's making me so angry. I'm not going to hire any more of Liu Yong's troops unless they're a magnificent hero. Liu Chang was captured. Thank you. I'm ripping his throne off. We're just putting him to the dungeon for the rest of his life and capturing him as soon as this battle's over. He could have just been one of our generals and conquered the world with us, but no. Want to go the hard way? Okay. Wow, that angers me. But it's part of war, and it's part of this game, and it's so fun. That's what adds to the suspense of this game. The fun, the action, the story, history. So he's running like a coward. He even ran out of the building. And then he pops his head back in like a little weasel. So I don't think I've been attacking from my castle this whole time, but now that I recognize it, we'll do a lot more damage. Should have did a fireball attack. So we got some suppression going on. He's running around my castle, getting little attacks in. Confuse. Oh, I almost clicked in the wrong space. Confusion I don't think worked. And the rain comes out. It's a very close battle. He's nullifying our outnumbering forces because, for one, he captured one of my guys that had 1,000. No, he made him switch. He didn't even capture him. He said, hey, come join us. Give us those troops, too. And now he's doing the runaround. So, Liu Jiang becoming a hotspot. And I waste a move there and don't attack. Wow, come on. This mother freaker. Give me the fire attack. Nope. Just gonna add the regular attack. Let's go. Give me no wind. Yes, the fire attack worked. And then we hit him while he's in the fire. And now he can't attack my castle. Should we do combat? This is Huang Zhu. Let's see his war skill 66. Let's try a combat. Because we don't even know who he sent. No combat. Zhuo Jin refused to combat. So we took the advantage back. And then for some reason I can't hit a simultaneous attack. So we're just going to keep hammering him, surrounding him and attacking him from the castle as well, and try to get this close win and try to defend his land after that, because he might just continue to attack me. Liu Yong is becoming the new Liu Bei, although I think he's worse. So we have our third rival, our third enemy in the realm. The battle continues next month. A pesky little defense battle. Liu Yan has revoked our alliance, and he goes to war in Yong'an. So we are facing new troubles, and we can't defend it. He takes it from Sun Jing. Probably captured Sun Jing as well, one of our family named people. So we're facing all types of different problems here. Now, Zhou Yu has encountered a new year of January, but he's got a lot of things to face. So he's going to have to start using his diplomacy here. First, I want to make an alliance with Ma Teng. Offer him 10,000 food. If he says no, he says no. Then we're going to try, I think, to attack Liu Yan. Nope, Monte denied it, and I will back out. Because I'm not going to keep giving him deals. It's not that important. Alright, so first thing we're going to do is attack. Right away. I lied. We're going to draft. We're going to attack next turn, because I'm always hesitant to attack right away. Song Zhong. Develop 600 goals for 6 months. That's some good farming. So we have Manchong, and we are going to go to war with Yuan Shu. Because we can't go here, right? Yeah. So. Tai Mao. Ma Wan has the cavalry. Zhu Sheng with the bows. And Guo Xi on the foot, on the feet. Although, should we keep it? No, yeah, we're good. We'll bring 900 gold. And a good amount of food. Reinforcements we can ask for from here, but we need them kind of, but we'll still ask. Alright, there are no officers available. So we just have to go in with just us. Peng Tong's in charge again. Allied reinforcements have been sent from Yuan for Yuan Shu. So we're going to war, and we have another war defense dwindling. We need to work on our diplomacy too in the future. So here we go, Manchong's first battle as well, and he is a great advisor. Tai Mao is back in battle, he's been in battle a couple times. Ma Wan, also new. Zhu Sheng used to serve Yuan Shu, so we gotta watch for him switching. Same with Guo Xi. So this is gonna be an untrustworthy battle here. Just watch your backs. So, Yuan Shu outnumbers us in this battle by a very small amount before the reinforcements come. And you know what that tells me? That tells me I need to flee right away. So here's my leader. Flee. Send everybody home. Hopefully I picked the right city. I think it's Xiang Yan. Oh, I sent him to the wrong city, but oh well, we can mix it up. So he outnumbered us. He built up, so we're going to have to play smarter. I knew Yuan Shu would be more of a smarter enemy. As far as Liu Yan goes, though, that angers me. We definitely need to attack him. He can't have nothing there. So we just tested the waters, and Yuan Shu might retaliate. Because he might not like that we did that, and he might realize he outnumbers us. So here we go, back to the defense. And it looks like we are maybe losing. Which is not acceptable. So we gotta play every move smart, and we gotta hit him with as much force as we can. Is there a fire? Didn't work. I don't know why they didn't let me get that attack either on the second trooper. Why aren't they letting me get that attack there? He's gonna end up winning. Another failed fire. This time they at least let me get the attack. Another failed fire. Hangzhou was captured. Hanzi is on his own. It comes down to the last numbers. A risky fire at this tack fails. Back and forth, rain comes. And we lost. Hanzi has to flee with 76 men remaining. And he was captured. Hopefully they set him free, or that's a big loss. It's a time of losses. Liu Yang. So I'm lost at words now. We lost another defense that was similar, kind of easy, because our equipment really isn't up. So point Juma, the governor. Thank you. That helps us there. Manchong's governor here. I see who's governor there. Of course, it's Yu Jin. Can't control that city. And then we got people spread out throughout. Xinjiang. He's enjoying a nice city to himself. Military. War. Hella food. So much food. We're requesting reinforcements from Jin Yuan. He's probably going to say no. Nope, there are no officers available. Hold on. Oh well, let's go to war with what we have. Try to take this land back from Liu Yan, our old ally, who just got balls out of nowhere. Zhou Yu starting in the woods, and Tai Mao is only ally here. So I skipped the raid screen, so I don't even know if I'm outnumbering him. I imagine I was by a lot. So there could be pitfalls, but I'm not too worried about it. And he has no reinforcements capable of getting to this castle. So we're heading right to the first gate we see. We don't know which one he is stationed in. Oh, yes, we do. I think I see the castle on the other side. I'm not even going to waste my time. I'm going to head to this gate. Ah, fudge. Never mind. Come back. Rain falls here. We are attacking Liu Yan, our ex-ally. He was allied for a while. He revoked the alliance. He tried to attack us, took our land that we couldn't defend because there was no general there. So I look at the battle screen and I realize this battle is way closer than I thought. I do have a slight 1,000-ish advantage, but I only have foot troops. That's another thing to remember. So if we lose this, we will really be in deep water. Fuck! A wasted attack on the wall. Alright, so we gotta go through this side of his castle, the stronghold, to get to the main keep. And we make our way in. I believe this is Yang An. It's nighttime and we arrive inside. We only have a small point advantage and we do not want to fall into any bad traps. We might have to make a duel. I think both of these officers are decently capable in war. But if we lose a duel, it would define the whole map. Okay, if we can besiege the second gate, we'll get things started. See if we can take our land back, and then we're going to have to build up to defend against Yuan Shu as well, and it's going to be hard. Putting all these resources at stake just to hold out our lands. Batter the walls down to 21. So sad that Hanzi was captured. We're in. We made our way in. We're going to fight the final enemy, and if he's in the castle. And he is. It's one troop inside the castle. I don't know how I feel about that, because when I attack it, I lose. When I defend it, I lose. I guess it goes on morale and all that. Try charging it. Tao Mao is captured. Wow. So it's just going to be a one-on-one for the next couple turns. And just see whose men fall first. But remember, Tao Mao did not have that many troops. And Zhou Yu drops. Why are we so weak here? Maybe because our troops need to be rallying and training more. We got a lot of dud soldiers out here. And that battle will continue next month. So a lot of bad things going on here. A lot of sketchy things going on here. We're gonna have to draft troops here just to defend our land. And then we're gonna have to train them as well. Luckily he's good at training. Just do one turn. We need to get our farming up, but we don't even have that. Supplies were sent from Ling Ling to Chai Sang. That's good. At least are some of our... Uh-oh, Yuan Shu attacking us once again while we're at war. Easily takes it. The war is still going to continue, but we lost the land, so hopefully we gain one. Dong Zhuo is attacking Han Fu. So we lost that because there was some reinforcements sent. Liu Yang stays put. I hope Wang Lang attacks Liu Yang's second city. That way I can attack his little new one. Yuan Shu just took one of our lands. Liu Yang, we're at battle with him right now, and it looks like he might win. So here we are, Cha Sang, one of our only cities we have generals to actually control, develop the farmland. Liao Hua, rally the troops, and I have a feeling we might lose this city sooner than later. So we're gonna go back to our battle in Yong'an, which we really need to win due to the loss to Yuan Shu. But we're already losing this battle. Let's move back for a second. A lot of fire. Nope, wind is not in our favor. Try another fire. It worked at least, but it looks like it might burn us. Yep, it burned myself. So I'm gonna have to flee to be smart. Flee to Jiangling, and we can take another loss, but now it's just our time to grow, not be so eager, develop everything. So that border right there, the western border, Yuan Shu and Liu Yan can fight for that for right now. And Hong Kong Kong has left to serve Ma Tang from Liu Yan, so that's what he gets. So here we have Zhou Yu in his new land that he had to retreat to. Let's develop the farming here, even though it's superb. Sell some food. Got 500 gold now. And we only have two officers here. Chai Sun. Not looking so good here. We would like to search, but we'd also like to draft. 2,900. Give him that, and then train those guys too. For three turns. So So we're trying to recover and get steady down south. We took some losses. Yuan Shu is invading Dongzhuo now. So I'm glad to hear it's not me. But they're at a battlefield. Not at his home castle. And Yuan Shu's won. So he's growing more powerful. And it's getting more scary because it's going to be hard for Man Chong to defend that edge. Luckily we got him. A responsible general ruler that can be smart and make good decisions there. While Zhao Yu deals with Liu Yan right there and supplying the eastern conquest as well. Speaking of him, we're going to try to recruit Kuei Yong. Switch, we need you, my friend. Thank you for joining us. You have good war skill and army skill. It's very mediocre, but it's better than certain people. So we use you as a military officer. Thanks for joining. Okay. Let's develop the forms. No. Military. Train. Jinjuan for 4 turns. Zhu Mao. Let's buy some equipment. Buy 1,200 horses, aka 12. And then your buddy here is training. So let's see what Liu Yong or Yuan Shu or Liu Yan decide to attack me this turn. I have 3 rivals at the moment. And we've had a nice episode here where we lost things. A lot, a couple cities and a couple people. We lost Han Zi, he was captured. Sun Ce was captured last episode. Sun Jing was captured. We have a lot of lands, but we're definitely not stable right now. And our name is left to Zhou Yu to decide. So we'll give him 4 months to rally. They took the tax rate up here, it looks like. But it's not hurting anything, so we'll leave it. Develop forms again. Supplies were sent from Ling Ling, that's good. Liu Yong does not attack us. And fall is coming. So the demeanor has changed. Yuan Shao is attacking though, Liu Bei. It is the year 196 AD. Yuan Shao has won and has exterminated Liu Bei from the populace. But he was set free and he went into exile, so he could pop back up. Now there's like 5 or 6 leaders in exile. Uh-oh, Zhu Sheng keeps having secret meetings with Yuan Shu, which could mean Yuan Shu is also planning an attack and then trying to get him to switch during the attack. We'll remember not to give him any troops. My question is, was Man Chong captured? Because I think he was. Yeah, Man Chong was captured as well. No, he wasn't. Thank goodness. Wow, okay. So we'll give him 10,000 troops. Zhu Sheng looks like he's been plotting a switch. We don't want to give him money. I don't know if they just hired Chen Lan or what. So we'll give him 1,000. This dude has seemed like he's been pretty loyal. And then Ma Wan was not a captive, so he can hold troops too. That's really good that we just decided to do that and look. We definitely needed to make sure Man Chong is the governor. I would have been very upset if he was captured. So we can't do anything here for the moment. And now we have Man Chong. in charge of a very important keep. We're gonna have to draft troops here. Looks like Deng Chan, best at drafting. I've had him for a while, and I did capture him to get him. 2,900 troops. We're gonna spread him out to who we think is the most important. The same people we just were assigning troops to, because Peng Tong had to give up his ruler troops. We're gonna give the recruits that are new. We'll give them the main troops. Although I want to give him enough to ride those horses, the cavalry, take outfit his army with cavalry. So we'll give him 1,700. I guess we're gonna have to trust Guo Xi because we need more people to fight. And then we'll give Man Chong 10,100. Now all those troops need to be trained. So luckily we have two military advisors that are good at training. And then we need to develop our farms. Peng Tong. 6 months for 600 gold. That'll really help. Market, sell. Man Chong can sell some food. And then we're going to buy some equipment. And pretty much everyone's not good. Liu Xian is the closest thing. But we realize our equipment's not bad, so we're going to buy horses instead. We'll buy 1,000 horses. Now we have 27. So I want to do one thing. I want to go to military and assign troops. To switch up, now we can have something different going on. What we want to do is try to get Ma Wan to hold 2,700. That way he can carry the cavalry in the battle. And we're feeling better about our battle circumstances, so let's get these guys to rally the troops as well, and then we'll end this turn here. Stronger army, more train, more equipment. See him getting pretty strong up there. But we did lose two lands, Yong An, and I forgot the other one we lost, maybe Shang Yong. We also lost Han Zi, and we lost a couple good officers we did not want to lose. Finally, Liao Hua has done his task and he can search for a new officer for 2 months. Dong Zhuo plotting strategy. Liu Yan, surprised he didn't attack me, neither did Liu Yong. Back to our turn here. August, heading towards the new year. Getting better than what we were. Let's develop floodgate here just for emergencies. Let's search, but we can't. Military, but we can't. Everyone's assigned a task. Back to Man Chong, who's in an important position here. His economy is excellent. So at that point, we're going to draft some new troops again and just try to make this a very powerful city. 2,800. I'll tell you what, let's give Chen Yong the same amount of heavy bows we have so we can carry those, and give Man Chong a massive army, 14,000. Keep training those army, keep rallying those army, that's going on right now. So we can also build some ships, which we don't need, we got plenty, and there's only navy down below. So back to Zhu Mao. I'm going to have him develop the farms once again. Keep building them up. Already have Liu Hua searching. And then supplies were sent from Ling Ling. Yuan Shu looked like he was going to go to battle, but he didn't. Uh-oh. Hu Yang. Looks like maybe Liu Bei. Nope. Zhang Yang tried to revolt and failed. Jiang Ling has been received. Zhou Yu just trying to get everything back together that fell apart on him. That Jin Yuan train. Develop our farming again. And next turn we'll sell some food even though the new year's coming. Back to Mahjong. I'm eager to attack here pretty soon. $2,800 again. We'll give Huo Jun, even though it's scary because at any point he could switch on us. We'll give him a lot of troops. We'll keep these guys the same so they can carry the equipment into battle. Although we'll just give him 3 so he can carry our bows. And we'll give him that smacking 17,000 amount. And then we need to train those guys and rally those guys. Training's still going on. 2 months of rallying. Economy is beastly. Floodgate doesn't need to be worried about either. It's pretty high. Let's just develop the economy some more. Why not? That's how you just keep it going. Go to the market. Let's buy some more equipment. Cavalry. $500 puts us at 32. And then next turn we'll sell some food. Chai Sang. Back down here. We're going to go to military. Draft. We're going to use all the gold because the end of the year is coming. And we want to make this city much stronger so we can defend against the oncoming force. But we didn't actually use all the gold, which is good. Then we're going to go to the market. We got enough horses. We need to buy the other equipment. Leo Hua. Buy some basic bows. By 11, which is 1,100, and then if we had another officer, we'd sell some food. Han Fu looks like he's going to war. To the battlefield to fight Yuan Shao. And I think we're gonna end our turn here in the new year of January. End the episode, I'm sorry. Let's go see what's going on, and then maybe we'll make another one. So there's another secret meeting. It's actually Man Chong. They would never be able to recruit him. Yuan Shu going to war now with Dong Zhuo in Chang'an, but Dong Zhuo sending reinforcements. So Yuan Shu's troops were crushed. So I'm planning this attack here, and I already know how I'm going to set it up. So here's Jian Ling. I'm going to plan to get my land back from Liu Yan soon enough. Let's sell some food himself. 381 gold and go to the market. Buy 500 horses, go to military and just train for 1 month. Alright. And then here we go, military, let's go. Let's go to war with Yuan Shu. Man Chong, oh, nope, wait, we gotta wait. We got guys that are still on tasks. So if that's the case, we're gonna beef up our everything. Train one more turn. Can we rally one more turn? No, we're already good on that. Let's go to market and buy any more equipment we might need. And then at that point, sell a little food. And then what we're gonna do is personnel, military assign, which we can't. Guess all our military advisors are busy. Let's have one person search for new people. And then develop floodgate. We haven't done it. We want to see all green, so on our board. There we go with that. Back to Jumao. All I can say to him is train your military. Rally your military. That will end our turn. Hopefully we don't get attacked again. Yuan Shu? Nope. What about Liu Yan? Liu Yan? Nope. Okay, so our battle plan should be good then. See, the sad thing is, taking that land. Uh-oh, Yuan Shu. But luckily, he's attacking Dong Zhuo once again. He was upset about his last defeat. Dong Zhuo unable to send reinforcements, and he lost his land. Yuan Shu gaining some real power, but we're going to lighten that power here in a second. Although, we're going to put our city at risk when we do that. So Zhou Yu, all he can really do is sell food and develop things or search for new people. Oh, recruitment. Zhu Li. Switch to our side. No, wait. Visit. And he decided to join when I visited him. So he's more of a military officer, but is... Yeah, he's a military officer. So we got more military officers now. That's always good to add to our forces. We can search again. Kuyong can search, and then we can train for one turn again. Jiang Yang, Man Chong, military war. Let's see if it's time. Yep, it's time. 17,200 heading to battle. Huo Jun taking the bowman. Zhu Sheng, we'll see if he's on our side or not. Ma Wan taking cavalry. Guo Xi taking cavalry. No, we have to leave somebody behind. Or do we? Yeah, no, we don't, because we have Peng Tong in them. But just for in case, we'll leave. We'll take the heavy bows with Chen Lan and leave Guo Xi behind for one military officer. Take all our gold. Take a lot of food. And we'll leave Peng Tong in charge. Reinforcements were sent for Yuan Shu. We'll see if it's going to be outnumbering, if he has an advantage, or we'll see. This is before the reinforcements get there, by the way. You gotta remember that when you read the first list. At least we have equipment this time. We're outfitted our army. Man Chong going into battle strong. So we really, really outnumber them before the reinforcements. After the reinforcements, we don't know. Uh-oh. Yuan Shu's troops have fled before the reinforcements were able to get there. So we scare them away. The best outcome. That was the best outcome. Ha. And all the people we captured, we're just going to capture them. No chance of them. Even Shang Zhong, who used to be our officer that we captured. No chance of them turning back. A very strong victory for Man Chong. I'm sure they're celebrating down here, partying, and saying good job. We just want to defend against Liu Yan. That's what they're saying. Sell some food. That was a petty number to sell, but it's alright. I should have rallied the troops instead. Man Chong now has to decide our next action. Well, he can't do nothing this turn because he just won the battle. Dong Zhuo! Sending a force to Yuan Shu's home capital. This will help us as well. Unless he wins. I mean, if he wins, it's good, but it's kind of sketchy. He didn't win, so that's good. I'm sure that was a strong battle right there. I mean, those are the top of the tops. Best of the best out here as far as generals, you know, rulers go. Dong Zhuo and Yuan Shu, they got the strong armies. Dong Zhuo sets to get his land back in Chang'an, because that was the capital where he moved it. Burned down the old one in Luoyang, I'm sorry. And he does, he gets it back, Dong Zhuo. So the turn resets here in December. It's almost a new year. I said I was going to end it on a new year. Although I do want to take my land back from Liu Yan and end the episode pretty much how I started it. Except for without a couple leaders that were captured and that land of Liu Jia. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to go to war here. And then we're going to ask for reinforcements from Manchong. And then he's going to send them. Ma Wan, give him the horses again. Chen Lan, heavy bows again. Wo Jin, regular bows. And we'll leave Ku Yong in charge. See if this is a bad move here in a second. At least Manchong gets to stay with his big troop number back at home. We didn't want him to leave because we need to protect that land we just took. So in an impulse attempt to take our lands back, Zhuo Yu also sends an attack force right after Manchong has successfully captured. Now when you see this number, this is before our reinforcements come, so obviously it's still close before our reinforcements come. That's what we want to hear. What we want to hear. So we're going to use the road to get us to his gates faster. And Zhou Yu is not able to move yet. Jin Juan, his first battle. Not the best, but we found him in a desperate time, so it's good that to have him. Still can't move. Pissing me off. I think he started in like some marsh swampland area. So let's move forward to the gates. And then finally Zhou Yu gets on the road. So we start besieging the western wall, the western gate. Almost stepped off the road, I'm glad I didn't. And by the time he gets there, we should be able to enter. Hopefully our reinforcements arrive. Foggy setting for the battle now. So a lot of crazy things have gone on in this episode. And then, just like that, I attack a bush. But yeah, we've lost land. Took it back, lost it, took it back. It's been a constant struggle of power. Fuck, and then I waste an attack turn. Can't have that, but it also gives a chance for my allied troops to arrive, and there they are. So we outnumber them, but not by a lot. It's going to be a pretty even fight. Hopefully when our equipment gets here, it gives us that advantage. So we're going to head right for the northern gate. With our reinforcements, the bow troops, and the horse cavalry troops that just won a successful intimidation victory on Yuan Shu. Which is why we got the morale to attack so fast and get it right back to where it was. We're still going to be spread slim and not have enough generals to maintain full power in the Southland, so it's going to be a fight really to recruit generals. So these guys heading down there, it's going to take them longer to make it into the main capital, but it doesn't matter how long it takes them as long as they get in. Fine, we'll move over. Okay. Let's go. We're inside. Attacking the north gate. We're gonna besiege the south. We're in the south as well. So, and we're looking for Liu Yan. He might actually be stationed. It's not him, but whoever officer he's got abandoned out here with no connecting cities, which is kind of screwy. So here we go. The enemy was here. They're sitting right there. And we couldn't see him in the fog. We fell into kind of a surprise attack. Northern gate about to fall. Reinforcements are at the wall. Haha. And we're surrounded by actually a couple of men. We walked right into a in the fog. Tai Mao has challenged Jin Yuan to personal combat. No, we will not accept it. Because we don't want to lose just like that. And Zhou Yu with the lack of mobility again. We're going to attempt a charge attack to link our two forces up together to give time for reinforcements to arrive. The gate down the one is going to break, but we're not going to be able to move through. So we have to wait. Here's their chance to attack. Simultaneous attack. Nope, three normal attacks on Jin Yuan, but he stays alive. So we move him back and we still get some attack points. Although we know their cavalry is going to do the same. Luckily we didn't plug that gate hole. And our archers might move into some range here. Alright. Still got the advantage. So Sun Jing, we got him. We captured him back. One of our original relatives of the main Sun Jian family. Someone we definitely need. We got Jin Zhuan, Zhou Yu fighting against some cavalry here in the main keep of Liu Yan, who took our city by surprise and by revoking our alliance. And we're taking it back before we end the episode. I'm like a gambler. Tai Mao, one of our old officers that was captured. I think we captured him back. So we can start recruiting some of our guys back. That'll help us. It'll be like redeeming ourselves. Which is pretty much what we did, except for Liu Jiang on the east side. We did not redeem ourselves for that just yet. Hit him with a simultaneous attack, show him the power of Wu. Reinforcements at the gates, they gotta be shaking in their boots now. If they're even wearing any. Hitting that second wall, although we shouldn't line up so we can all hit it. But whoever's controlling that first bow troop is being greedy. Zhou Yu attempts to charge through some horse units. He failed, but we're going to get some good attacks on it. Alright, so this time we're going to do what we said. We're going to move out the way and wait. Move here and wait, and then get double attacks so we can charge in faster. Although we sacrifice a turn. Simultaneous attack on the cavalry. We'll just wait here. Pretty much working them down now. Send another simultaneous attack. Got cavalry holding a good amount of troops. We got the walls down to 13 now, and our reinforcements are about to start bleeding in as we break the wall. So here's how we're going to do this turn. We're going to try to charge through with Zhou Yu. And it works. Then we're gonna move here and attack the castle, surprisingly, to get some hits on that. Our bow troop is in and our cavalry is also in. Heavy bows on their way. Smell the victory in the air. Hopefully we don't let it fall like we've done before. We'll hit the simultaneous attack here. Hit the fireball attack to our main castle. Enemy main castle. charge our horsemen in to get their attacks in on the castle. Bring the heavy bows in, and next turn they'll be able to attack as well. So it's becoming a close battle, which is kind of scary. We're going to attempt to charge through this cavalry here. Zhang Zhao, one of the actual Wu advisors for in real life that served under Sun Quan, Sun Jian's one of his children, third son or second son, whatever. So Zhang Zhao, we captured him. Could be fulfilling a destiny there. I don't know if it said captured or fled, but hopefully captured. Okay, because of that, we can surround the castle and hopefully work it down till it's over. Let's see if we can hit a bow attack from this far. No, we can't. Even with the heavy bows. Alright, so we're going to do simultaneous attack. That was deadly. Move in closer and start hitting that with firebolts, and that ends till next turn. Don't worry, I'm not going to end this episode until we take that. Even though it's December. So here we are. Lan Chang and Shang Yong. Recently taken. 17,000 troops here, but a big population of 52,000. So first thing I want to do is rally our troops with Zhu Chang, keep them ready to go in case they attack us. Second thing I want to do is go to market. No, we can't. So then the second thing I want to do is hire troops with all our remaining gold. And that turn, hopefully we don't get attacked. And then back down here to Chai Sang in the winter. Just develop the economy because the new year's coming. Plus we only have 54 gold, so you gotta take a risk. Search for new guys. Because we're gonna keep all of Liu Yong's captives. Keep him in the dungeon. Hopefully Yuan Shu doesn't attack, that's all I can say. Or hopefully Liu Yan doesn't attack from the north of Han Zhong. That would be bad. Yuan Chao invading Gongsun Zan once and for all, maybe to eliminate him or push him back. So it's a successful defense for Gongsun Zan. Han Fu and Kong Zhou have made an alliance. That's a good one to keep them alive up there around Cao Cao, who hasn't really done much. Alright, so they're going to start us in the new year now, January. Man Chong got a lot of gold. And he's going to use it to protect himself and hire 3,200 guards. And he's hit the max limit, I think, of holding, troop holding, 17,000. We're going to go ahead and train those troops. Zhu Chang, just one turn in case they attack us. We want to be ready. Chai Sang again. Develop the fields. And then train our troops. Liu Hua, two turns. And let's go back to battle. Here we go, back to the battle on Yongan. Hopefully we can get a successful capture and deal with the troops and then end the episode, because I've been waiting to end it, even though things are getting crazy. Simultaneous attack. There's no way we can lose with all these forces. If we do, I'll not play this game no more. Firebolts raining down on his castle. He's attacking one of our guys. We're hitting a simultaneous attack. More bows raining down. Alright, so I want to see info on my leader just so I don't lose. 355 troops. Smart that I look. We need to move Zhou Yu out of battle here so he doesn't get killed off. Hit him with some bows. arrows. Hit them with a charge or two. Protect Shoyu. I'm glad I looked before he lost there. Can't do bows for him, so we have to wait. Now, let's see. No simultaneous attack again. So we're gonna get a regular and a firebolt attack. Use our cavalry to charge through. It worked. And now we'll hit. Nope, can't hit a bow attack. Move in and still get some combat. A failed fireball on their part. Shoyu staying out of combat. We'll attempt this charge. More fire bolts. Hopefully we can take it soon. Attacking from all sides again. And they have a successful fire attack. We're still going to keep attacking. And shooting fire bolts. Move him out of the fire. And the fire goes away. And we pretty much have them almost to their last troops. And it won't even be soon enough that we can finish him. More fire bolts raining down. Cavalry's gonna charge through. If it doesn't work, that's good. We'll move my heavy bows back. If it does work, that's also good. Doesn't work. Heavy bows coming back into play. They can't attack yet. And he flees. I skipped it too fast and didn't see if I captured him, but we'll figure out right now. So it was a great one. We lost three lands and we got two of them back. Hopefully next episode we can be the one on the making the positive side. Soon Jang, welcome back, my friend. Tai Mao, welcome back, my friend. Zheng Zhao, I would like to introduce you to what is going to be your faction of Wu and serving Zhou Yu. We need you. Yan Yan, a great captive because he was one of Liu Yan's main officers. And a great warrior and a good general that we need to spread out. So that's a good win there. And we're going to capture them all. We're going to end the turn. That was a good win. All I can say about that. Great, great, great win. What's going on here with my computer? Cancel that. Save state so we don't mess it up. And then stop the recording. Why is it acting like it's such a big problem? This is some killer stuff. This is some killer stuff. What the hell is going on here? I can't damn end a damn video. But I'm still happy. At least I got to capture that land. I wish there was a Oh well, we'll do it the hard way. We'll do it the hard way. Man, what the hell?